In this video, I want to share updated results from the previous benchmark I ran between Rust and Zig. I got a lot of tips on how to improve Zig application as well as a couple of PRs, and it made a huge difference. I'll quickly go over optimization techniques and then run the benchmark again with the optimized code. I used the same setup and settings to generate load in this test. So in this test, we'll compare Rust with the Zig programming language. Specifically, I'll use Actix HTTP framework for Rust and ZAP framework for Zig. Additionally, I got a pull request from a Zig expert with a pure Zig implementation of HTTP server. And as always, I'll generate enough load to find the breaking point of each application. I chose the Actix framework based on the previous benchmark I ran between most popular Rust HTTP frameworks, Actix, Axum, and Rocket. Actix had the lowest latency and lowest CPU usage among the three. Next, we have ZAP HTTP framework written in Zig. It's essentially a wrapper around a C library, and based on the provided benchmark results, it should outperform Rust. When I ran the previous benchmark, I didn't compile application with all optimization flags. And just after a few minutes after I released the benchmark, I got a pull request with proper optimizations. Zig has four build modes. The first is debug mode, which is default and is applied when you run the build command like this. This default mode is what I used in the previous benchmark, which is why the ZAP application was so slow. The other modes are release fast, release safe, and release small. Release fast prioritizes performance and disables checks. Release safe prioritizes safety and keeps all safety checks. Finally, release small creates small executables. You can read more about building your Zig application and other settings you can apply on this page. I also got another pull request from a Zig expert with a pure Zig implementation of the web server using the same endpoints. Based on the local tests, it performed better than Rust, handling almost 200,000 requests per second. This test was performed on a Mac with M2 IRM based processor. The only difference I made was compiling the code in release fast mode to prioritize performance over size. If you're interested in learning Zig, I suggest going over the code in this PR. To run this test, I used production ready EKS cluster. I created two node groups, one with extra large instances to run applications, and another with four extra large instances to run the clients that generate the load. All the source code is available in my public GitHub repo, and you'll find the link in the description. Alright, let's go ahead and deploy all three applications to Kubernetes in AWS and let them run for about 10 to 15 minutes in idle state. Let's take a look at the CPU usage. Rust has the highest usage, and it's funny that pure Zig implementations CPU usage is so small that Prometheus and CI Advisor show 0% usage. Sometimes they can't even detect that it's running. On the other hand, we have memory usage. And as expected, ZAP has the highest usage. Let's take a closer look at actual usage. Actix uses 760 kilobytes. ZAP uses 22 megabytes. And pure Zig implementation uses around 1000 kilobytes. While this doesn't really mean much, it's a useful baseline for our applications. Alright, let me go ahead and deploy test jobs to Kubernetes to generate some load. I have 20 client pods for each application, and every 30 seconds, the number of virtual clients will increase by 1. So we start with 20 clients, and we'll probably reach around 4000 virtual concurrent clients by the end of the test. For the first couple of minutes, you can ignore latency until it stabilizes. At the beginning of the test, you can see that Rust has the lowest latency, while Zig and ZAP stay close to each other. The pure Zig implementation also uses much more CPU at the beginning. For this test, I set requests and limits to 2 CPU and 256 MB of memory, with each application instance running on its own separate node. Once in a while, you might see drops in availability, which is a ratio of successful requests divided by the total number of requests multiplied by 100. Since the average request duration is under 1 millisecond, I set the client timeout to 200 milliseconds. So when a client times out, you get 408 status code, which is reflected in the availability graph, and these drops represent client timeouts. By around 50,000 requests per second, you start to see clear differences between three applications. In terms of latency, we have pure Zig implementation first, followed by ZAP, and then Rust. CPU usage follows a similar pattern. Other metrics are not as important at this point. Occasionally, some clients will experience timeouts, but with 99.999% availability, only a few requests fail, which doesn't significantly affect most clients. At around 75,000 requests per second, pure Zig application starts to degrade and its latency increases. This is more or less the maximum number of requests pure Zig application can handle within a reasonable amount of time. At around 81,000 requests per second, it becomes clear that pure Zig implementation is falling behind, so I'll remove it from the graph at this point and revisit at the end of the test. Now, I'll keep only ZAP and Actix on the dashboard. If you watched the previous benchmark, you might remember that ZAP application compiled in the default debug mode could only handle around 83,000 requests per second. Let's see if optimizations made a difference. As we reach 100,000 requests per second, both applications show spikes in latency and availability. I would not recommend running these applications at around 60% CPU usage. Instead, you should scale them horizontally and set auto-scaling threshold maybe at around 50% CPU usage. But for now, we're trying to find out which application can handle more requests with lower latency. Let's keep going. By the way, you can still see the values for the pure Zig implementation, but it's not shown in the graph. You can even see that Kubernetes is heavily throttling it at this point. Now, we reached 125,000 requests per second, which is the maximum number of requests ZAP application can handle. Let's continue the test for a few more minutes. Alright, I got pretty much the same results for the Rust application as in the previous benchmark, processing around 160,000 requests per second. The ZAP application handled only 127,000 requests per second, with CPU usage close to 90%. Now, let me open each graph for the entire test duration and include pure Zig implementation. First, we have requests per second. If you can explain this behavior, like one application processes more requests with lower latency, please share your knowledge and experience. Next, we have client latency. Let me also show the latency before applications started to slow down. Next is CPU usage for each application. Here is the memory usage. Availability graph. And finally, we have CPU throttling from Kubernetes. If you can improve any of these applications, please create a pull request. Also, let me know what I should test next. And I have other benchmarks on my channel. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.